operation. It is obvious that our hopes to find one that had somehow been scaled attack were unfounded. Moscow was apparently hit especially hard. The new data confirms that fallout makes it completely impossible to live there. Only Novosibirsk might be marginally worse, where...
with lights still on. we had to take them back to the colonel. By the way, I brought your car. It's at the dock. It's amazing the lift still works with all the cracks in the bunk.
Mother told me they had to repair many times, and other things too.
Keprakme. Thank you, Artyom. This is for you. Father gave it to me when I was little. Damir says there's a little girl on your train. Give it to her. May it bring her luck.
You people are lucky. Most of the Monaibaile are raiding all their best troops. If they were all here, you'd be dead already. But now, we have a chance to change things.
Monaibaile translates to something like oil-rich people. Oil drillers, I guess.
Listen to me. I'll tell you where to go now. When outside, go right. The road there used to lead to the sea. To port.
Anna should be around there. Contact her. She probably found something interesting. I'll stay and try to find out more about these oil drillers. We'll contact the base as soon as I get any useful information. Tell me, Gyul, how did this Baron come to power here? Well, see ya, John. Good luck.
But some backup would be welcome.
Copy that, Anna. Forwarding your coordinates to our scouts.
Listen up, everyone! The Baron is about to speak! Listen up, everyone! The Baron is speaking! Now, people! I heard a radio chat with the boss of that train gang! And I don't even know what to say! But now, that boss is an according to goodness, Colonel! And he's not on a joyride here, oh no! He's been sent here on a mission by the Supreme Command!
He was rather vague on the specifics, though he says his mission is secret.
And if you think this is all there is, you're gravely mistaken. Can you imagine where this colonel is hailing from? Straight from Moscow!
Spoken. Come on! Come on, inside!
Hey, fool! Artyom, I have the mirror on the line here, so take a seat, I'll be with you soon.
What a storm! Made of sand, no less! But, get in the sand!
Alright, Miller, over and out! You got them? Great job, Artyom! Great news! Artyom got the maps!
Well done, Artyom!
That is such a relief.
Idiot, get started with these. I'll join you later.
Here,
there's a lot of data. The sooner we analyze it, the better. We have the maps. Now we have to find a way out of this place. And that's the hard part. We need water for the Aurora and the crew. People are going down with dehydration already. It's only getting worse. We also need fuel. The local bandits have it all. I had already contacted their so-called Baron, but his terms proved to be unacceptable. He'll hold us where they get the water, but naturally, the well is guarded. The mirror recon to the place, and says we could infiltrate it stealthily. So, Artyom, when you're ready, go rendezvous with the mirror. Your goal is to bring water to the Aurora. Failure is not an option. Good luck, Artyom. We are all counting on you. Crest, how's the weather?
The storm seems to be over. I'll go back to the post.
Grandpa Yermak, don't you have any water left at all?
Where would I keep any?
What have you got, idiot?
What can I say? We clearly didn't come here in vain.
Artyom,
figured out?
Thanks for coming by to see the guys.
In your untouchable reserve, of course. Uncle Artyom, is this for me? Wow, thank you! Look, Grandpa Yermak, I have my own canteen now.
Well, now we'll have to ask for some water. And you have your own untouchable reserve.
Wow, thank you! Mom, Uncle Artyom.
Sure seems so. The radiation levels are plotted in color.
They even have the radiation level dynamics here.
Artyom, while you were out, I finished making one more thing for the Tihar. The workbench is at your service.
You can go wild there. Our situation is critical. A few more days, and we won't be able to fight off a pack of wild dogs, much less the bandits.
somebody wiped our post in the ruins. Judging by the sign, it's that train guy. I just called him out on it, but they kept denying everything. The thing is, some boys saw them driving a car our people at the post had. Newcomers are total losers. So you can stay alert.
As you were, everyone. The Baron has spoken. I fucking give up! Just don't. Hey man, we're cool. I give up. You, Mircea! I know not you at all. You come check on us, yes? From Baron come from power, yes? Forgive Mircea, I stupid slave, know nothing, nothing at all, nothing! Master up there, yes, master know all, yes, yes. Give us all one.
to live through cold long nights. Hello, good irony. Why you are? What here? Do? Who let? Master, no expect you. Go away. No, go there. Already, you can't. Only flame will punish. Do how you want. Master will teach you. He will.
Yes. Other slaves get to be warrior. Get to fight for holy flame.
You damn bitch! I did to love me! And now I spare my holy flame! Ah, fucking bitch!
I'm not going to die for some fat.
Thank you. Not kill, Mirza! Slave do nothing bad! Nothing!
Thank you. there's nobody around. Who'd even go here?
Hey, where did you go?
Hey, come on, bro!
Calm the fuck down already! You've nowhere else to go!
Oh,
everyone! The Baron is about to speak! Listen up, everyone! The Baron is speaking!
We're going to have a grown-up conversation here, gentlemen. So move your tribals away from the radios. Dan? Good. It has come to my attention that Shelgen told people that I should not have burned Sweaty. And that Sweaty was an okay guy. And I overreacted over some stupid shit we intended for the tribal. Who cares if we got drunk? We need the slave side. And took the link into the Holy Flame. Well, I have just put Shelgen down. Nothing could be done about that. Those of you who he owes can get remuneration from his wife. She's worth it. So, to avoid further incidents like this, I gotta tell you people something here. Especially the new ones. Tell me, why do the tribals obey us? Is it because they fear us? It partly is.
You were away, I scouted it out a
but
bit.
But fear before man is not absolute. When your life is so shit,
as you might suspect, we're approaching the spring through the back door. Kuhl says lots of people used to live in these...
basically a real town. But then the geysers opened up and they all had to flee.
To flee. Let's go! Well, the bridges are burnt now. Let's climb a bit higher to get a better look around. The cave isn't going anywhere. What's that, huh?
Ah, Shaitan!
Stupid bats! Yeah, this place is totaled. When setting out, I kind of had hopes of finding something about my people, if not my relatives. But now I find out. And it hurts. Steady, steady. Aha! Right at the entrance. Get ready, Artyom. Charge the torch, check the filters and other gear. I have this feeling, a vaguely unnerving one. Well, to hell with the feelings. Here, let me give you a boost. Oh, wait! Artyom, masks on! So, the war really did put people back into the Stone Age. Cave, paintings and all.
drifted out here for some time. I wish we'd gotten here earlier. How many people lived here? Everything is built up. Let's try walking around. Looks like we're almost out. Follow me! The passage to the spring! Let's go! Another cave-in! My filter's almost done for. Look, light! Here. Well, the air seems all right. Masks off.
Well, it's a crawl from here on.
Says the locals follow every word the oilmen say. So let's try to do it quietly, without the unnecessary bloodshed. The slaves are innocent. Look, water. See that car? I'll move there and hide behind it.
The gate is controlled from that tower. When you open it, I'll rush the car through and you leap atop the tank.
Good luck, and try not to kill anyone but the oilmen, all right?